G'day guys and girl, my name's EB Nispel, and I like to cut things with my left hand even though I'm right-handed. Now, today what I'm going to be simply covering what kind of loadouts that you can use for the tank, what each loadout does, as well as giving you my personal recommendation, what is the most effective loadout to use in 2042 for this game. Do remember that this is a very early video, so this is not even after about 1 week of the game's lifespan. So do remember, if you come and back to see this video, it might age over time given when patches come out and balance and other things come along. Even maybe new content, who knows, maybe they might change a couple of things or add a new couple of perks to the vehicles that you can switch up on the meta on. So just remember that. So hopefully I've given you some good advice early on in the game's lifespan, and I hope you enjoy today's content. Now, before I go on any further, a large amount of you are very much new people to my channel, and not to go through my statistics, there is about 60% of you that are new and haven't subscribed to my channel. But any chance today, if you find that this new video was helpful, you learned something, or you know, you just want to see some more content from me and to make some more comments and ideas in the future, hit that sub button, leave a comment, or if you're feeling generous, a like, as usual, let me know in the comment section down below what beverage you're having today, and let's get right into it. We have the MPAT shell, which, if you can read the description here, is a high velocity with a limited area of effect. Think of it like your AP shell, or kind of like all-rounder shell from previous Battlefield titles. Then you have your heat, which is meant to be a high explosive round, which is meant to have limited armor penetration at the increase of area of effect. So that means it has more splash damage and a one hit kill radius for that, so that you have a bit more of a general easier time trying to get infantry out of decent cover and hard to reach places. And then the stealth shell works somewhat similar to what it does in Battlefield 4, where it auto locks onto the target and hits its target. As far as I know, from just some of the small little bit of testing that I've done here and there, it seems to have the same kill time as the main shell, but it has this ability to lock onto its target and keep track of it perfectly, so you're really highly unlikely to miss at the cost of having almost no splash damage. And given with the hit reg and hitbox issues in the game currently, it's honestly better that you go with these two at this point in time. Also, I just don't think this is very rewarding to use in the first place. If you put some hours into these two, you're going to be better off in the long run. So, until we get some data on actually damage values and if it does anything else extra, I personally haven't been shot at and noticed that if it hits me from ability every time, it's just something that I haven't noticed yet. And we have now the secondary weapons, which we have the cocked a lightning machine gun and the heavy machine gun. Now, this is actually a really easy choice between the two, and you're going to always be choosing the HMG over the other. Why is that? Well, yeah, sure, you have generally less of a overheat mechanic on the LMG, so it doesn't overheat as much before you have to let it relax, cool down, and then start using it again. But the difference in time to kill between the two is pretty noticeable, and also this generally has better damage over distance, with how tanks work in this game, where it's promoting you to be in medium and long range engagements so that you have actually better tracking and hitting your targets, it's going to be more worthwhile to use the HMG. So there's almost no reason why you will really need to use this at all, so just go straight. As soon as you get this, keep it as that always. You can always flip between the two here, but personally I would be using this over any of the others, because if you have a little bit of aim and a bit of good shell prediction, etc., and how to put it into buildings so that you can get people out of there and kill them, you're going to be better off having that extra damage that you can do to vehicles. Oh, probably didn't highlight that before, that this does actually less damage to vehicles, so it's more worth, that's the difference between these two. Be better at killing infantry, or be better at killing vehicles. So I honestly think it's more worthwhile to have this, because the splash damage is pretty generous in the first place with it, so you won't have that much of a hard time. Now, the equipment slot is kind of lacklustre, there's really no depth to it, and once you finally get to the thermal smoke package, which basically it does what these ones kind of do, except with a different dispersed of how the smoke works, it's just going to be better for you to use the thermal smoke package. And why? Because it removes lock-ons from you, so you might as well get that so that you kind of get the best of bang a buck between all of these, plus some extra effect at removing lock-ons. Now the repair system is just basically going to instantly re-engage any part of your vehicle that's disabled, as well as start the healing process and boost it up to a similar point before it starts to slow down a little bit. Now the weapon station, to be honest, as much as you use the minigun can be at deleting people, I find the HMG is way more accurate and it's more worthwhile to tracking people. So if you seat switching and you need to kill people that are close to you, that are getting behind you real quick, you want to use this and it'll be really easy for it to kill you. But given the nature of how aircraft work in this game, they're quite easy at rolling vehicles and tanks. This, once you spend the hours into it and learn the tow missile in this game, it's going to be honestly worthwhile, and your personal enjoyment of the game will be much higher. You can go for very satisfying shots on aircraft, taking them out, and you coming out of the scenario with scotch-free, unharmed. The only problem with this, though, is if you have a friendly spawn off you that's not too well suited at using this tool to its full extent, you're going to be having no use out of it whatsoever. I also would like to highlight at this current time, anytime you move your turret left or right, while someone's trying to shoot that, it will actually make the rocket sway left or right depending which way the turret turns. So you can actually throw your gun's aim off when they fire it. So it's worthwhile locking up your turret when they go for the shot. Otherwise, honestly, if you can get into a squad of a couple of mates and they're doing all their own things, you can pretty much master seat switching through all the different utilities that the tank has so that you can put it to the full effectiveness that it can be done. So if you're having to deal with lots of things that are kind of dropping down you, so like Sunny being the character that has their wingsuit that comes from higher ground advantages to come down and drop an EMP nade on you or some C4, you can use this to kind of counteract that, or last minute save. So that, for example, if the turret is facing forward and there's a guy behind you and it's not going to be fast enough for you to turn your turret around, you just seat switch by pressing F2 or whatever your assigned key is, get into that, turn around and instantly just delete them. It's a skill to master, just multitasking all those different seats and the utility that you have, and it was something that was what really set apart some of the in casual tankers to the professionals in this game. So those are the options you would use if you use the tow or the heavy machine gun. Like, it's fun, but not more really worth your time. The 44mm volley pod, it's like a grenade launcher, but it has very limited range. You have to really get close to the enemy before it becomes even useful. And there's better choices on this list, which we'll get to, which pretty much make that obsolete. The canister shell has the same story of being very limited in its range, but once in within that said range, will one-tap people. But there's better gadgets, which we're about to cover, which make it obsolete as well. The rocket pods, it does a little bit of damage to infantry. It's kind of a little bit wonky to aim for it, but what it does is does that little bit of extra damage to vehicles to finish them off. So if you get into some situations where you have multiple vehicles to deal with, it can be kind of a game changer a little bit for that, doing that extra little bit of extra damage. And the kinetic grenade pods, now this I found very useful. So it would bounce around, bouncing off objects, and just had an insane amount of splash damage. So how you would use this is if an enemy peeked you, shot a rocket, they go back to reload, and in the time they're reloading, get ready to come back and shoot you again. If you spam nades to where that angle that they're going to come from, they're not going to be able to come back out and shoot you. It's kind of like area denial and keeping yourself safe so that maybe you can get a little bit of extra HP off, reload your shell, reposition, or any other things that you want to do from that situation. Now, out of all of these right here, funny enough, this is going to be really weird to say, this is probably the most skillful thing out of all the pod launches you have. It's a bit of a meme, but I do feel like if you can actually master this and be somewhat reliable with this, you can be an absolute pest to people with this thing right here. It was pretty fun to toy around with it on the AI range just to see what it was like, but I do feel like at the end of the day, the rockets and the kinetic launcher are going to be the best choices. If you want to invest some time in using the mortar launcher and using it to get people off roofs that are kind of like top down in you, I think it would actually be worthwhile and actually could save you some hassle in some really unique situations. And as far as the commander seat goes, you can't really change these options anyway, and but that's what they are anyway, which is just a sensory array which spots enemies around you with your viewpoint, and this one just does a bit of a scan for you. Now that will cover basically the whole entire loadout of what I would recommend. Just to iterate exactly once again, if I hasn't been very clear in the video as to what I think the best loadout is to use at this current time, the first default shell that you have at the start, stick with that. If you want to spice things up and you're fighting, you're not getting to vehicle gain range, use the heat. At this point, not worthwhile. As far as secondary weapons go, this is the go, not worthwhile at all. So use your HMG. Equipment, these two are meh, use thermal smoke package. Equipment, always use the repair system, will save you. Plus, nothing else to choose, no death. We need to fix that. As far as these goes, heavy machine gun and tow launcher. Weapon pods, rocket pods, and kinetic grenade pods. If you want to be spicy, mortar. And then that's it. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's little short video on covering simply what the loader I think is best worthwhile using for the tank and mastering at this point. And I will get around to doing the other vehicles as well once I get some more time on my hands to cover them. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.